I am going to be playing roles on this 96-year-old player piano built in England. It still plays reasonably well, even though I restored it over 35 years ago. I've taken the panels off so you can see how this wonderful piece of engineering, almost 100 years old, works. A player piano will play the notes of music with 100% accuracy. The famous Vladimir Horowitz once said about another pianist, "He plays with all the accuracy of a player piano, but without as much emotion." By the use of hand controls such as these, and by pumping harder or softer with my feet, a player is able to modify volume, accents, and tempo, and even perhaps add some emotion. I'm an engineer, not a musician. Someone with real musical ability would be able to get much more out of the music roles than I can. Now on to the first role I'm going to play tonight. Huseyn Kala Mazel Tov. Many people are surprised to discover that this quintessential piece of Jewish music is not just a traditional Jewish folk tune, but was written by Sigmund Mogulescu in 1906, a superstar of the Yiddish theater. When he died in 1914 in New York, the whole Lower East Side came to a standstill as tens of thousands of people watched the funeral procession. Originally, the term klezmer meant a pure or impoverished musician who played Jewish music. By 1980, the meaning had completely changed and now simply meant a style or type of music. The reissue of the earlier QRS roles was thus called klezmer. The first part of this music on the roll is unfamiliar. I don't know whether this was part of the original sheet music, but you will certainly recognize the second part. Between each tune that I play, there'll be a 15 or 30 second pause while I rewind one roll and put on another one. Now. Thank you. This next piano roll is called Yossel. It was a hit from the Yiddish theater in 1923. Note the reference to music rolls on the sheet music as soon as I put the sharing on. Okay. Now note the reference to music rolls on the sheet music cover. One of the great attractions of player piano rolls is that the song lyrics could be printed on the paper roll, synchronized with the music. This was the very first form of karaoke. Yiddish rolls were always printed in transliteration, just like Yiddish sheet music is printed. Since the music roll travels downwards, the lyrics must be read upwards. It does take a little bit of getting used to. Die Grüne Cousine, from the Yiddish theater. Let's start again. The Grüne Cousine, from the Yiddish theater, 1921. This type of song was known as a disillusionment song. The original in the theater had a dirge-like melody. By the time the sheet music was published and the piano roll produced, it had a very upmarket beat and became very popular. In 1942, this melody was used in a Benny Goodman recording, My Little Cousin. It then became a very traditional love song. Thank you. I like she, basically English lyrics. I like the tune, that's why I've put this one in my selection. If you go onto YouTube, you can find recordings of Aaron Lebedoff singing, "Oi, oi, I like she." It's a wonderful recording. Not the video, but just it's an audio. I love the name of this music role, Kreplach and Wervorenikus Freilach. It is better known as Der Stiller Bulgar, the Silent Bulgar. It was composed by the famous klezmer musician Abe Schwartz. The melody was used in a 1939 Benny Goodman hit, And the Angels Sing. I should mention that the klezmer role copies do not have the lyrics printed on them. It's unfortunate, but it's only the original reprint, the original ones that do have the lyrics on them.